Veldig bra. How's it going? I hope you're doing great. This is for Libra, Sun, Moon and Rising sign. Venus placement, 7th house placement. Over here we have Libra in your chart. This may or may not resonate with you. Please take what resonates and leave the rest. And I thank you so much for your likes, subscribes and your comments. I really appreciate you all. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I have had a lot of problems with my captions, as you know, perhaps, and I don't know why my caption do not work. Sometimes it works, sometimes it's not. Every thing to better it, to yeah, and I don't know what I'm doing wrong, if I do something wrong, or if it's someone that has hacked my app or something. I don't know. I hope for a solution soon. Libra energy, please, for today. Libra energy, please, for today. Page of Swords, the Hierophant, Ten of Wands, Page of Swords in reverse, someone is. Someone is letting their past holding them back. Yeah, excess materialism. What is this? Okay, I want to take three of this shaman oracle card and please spirit show me the meaning of this reading. The stuff, the earth keeper and the owl. And at the bottom of the deck, the witness, which have been coming out before, previously. This is the earth keeper. This is the owl and this is the stuff. I want to read from the book the essence, just as you're involved in co-creating your world, you are also responsible for its well-being. The earth keepers are dedicated to the stewardship of the earth and all life. They choose to hold the sacred dream of a planet where all beings live in peace, and where the rivers and the air are clean. Remember that everything you do has an impact for 7 generations. As you care for your body, you show your care for Mother Earth. So begin with the stewardship of your health. What are you putting in your mouth? Are you feeding on foods and thoughts that are not good for you? Start doing what you know will be good for you today. And the owl is the master of the night. She can see situations with perfect clarity, more so when it is dark, and it is able to discern truth when others are sightless. She helps you find your light and your lightness in the dark moments of your life, and to embrace the night as your ally, owl can bring you messages from the invisible world. She opens your ears so that you may hear the voices of the ancestors and you may acquire their wisdom and make it your own. All guards against self-deception and insist that your motives be pure and transparent to all. What is the message that you are not hearing, the situation you are not seeing with clarity? Owl invites you to wait patiently, bide your time until it's right to act, then do so decisively with no hesitation and remorse. And this is the stuff. The essence of the stuff is the symbol of authority. It holds the power to temper extremes. The stuff helps you find the right course of action, the way of the middle, and aids you to maintain your balance after you begin walking in that direction. Moses carried a serpent stuff through the desert, and with it he could summon the power of nature to heal or call plagues. The stuff reminds you of the impermanence of all things and that your authority must come from your deep longing to serve. You caught in the delicate balance between opposing forces, between masculine and feminine, between action and non-action. Use this to your advantage, as there can be no day without night, no low without high, no wrong without right. This is the time to take corrective action, beginning with your beliefs about what needs to be fixed or repaired. Let destiny take its course, nudging it slightly along. Yeah. And let us see further into this reading. This is someone who carry a burden. This is someone who is stuck. Yeah, this is someone who is stuck in their head. Too much burden to look to the future. Trapped in the devil. Knight of Pentacles for a long time. Page of Wands. Some bad news. The Hermit in reverse. And the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, someone is grieving about something. King of Wands in reverse. This is jealous. Pretty jealous person who's trapped in some old beliefs or regret something, standstill, Page of Pentacles, Eight of Cups, walking away to stability. But the road is blocked because of the King of Swords and the Star, I don't know. Yeah, it's like someone is blocked because of their devilish tendencies or trapped in devilish energy. What's the devil spirit? The Tower, sudden changes, upheaval, revelation, awakening, chaos, shifts. Yeah, it's like someone waking up to this. Why they are lonely, why they are withdrawal, being stuck, repeating past mistakes. Why is it like this? This person is asking. Yeah. Or if this is a person who can't ask these questions because they are too stubborn. The Six of Swords in reverse. Yeah. This is a choice. Yeah. You choose. You choose what you want to lead you. You know, is it the dark? Is it the light? Who do you choose? You can't serve both the light and the dark. You know, you have to choose. And yeah, try to manifest. Goal-oriented, financial opportunity, faithful messenger. And the Sun, feeling down, overly optimistic, delayed gratification, inner child, blocked happiness, pessimism. Yeah, this person is trapped in their own thoughts. Yeah, financial loss, poverty, lack mindset. This is a burden. So they can't, in their eyes, they can't move forward. There is nothing to look forward to. That's what I'm hearing. Because of delays, frustrations, resisting to change. Yeah. All of this talks about resisting to change. You know? Past holding you back. What's the past holding you back? The hype is this. Okay, there's a lot that is hidden. What's this excessive materialism? They think they have to have a lot of money to have someone, to charm someone. Someone is very impatient as well. Working, workaholic, holding on to this love. I'm sorry, I didn't show you the cards. Yeah, someone is working, workaholic. Someone is holding on to this love, can't forget about this love. And the King of Cups, this is someone who is in love with someone. The need for rest. Unhappy. Lack of fulfillment. Greediness. Laziness. Greediness. I don't think it's laziness in this case, but yeah. This is someone who think they can't change because of their past or something like that. They have done too much in the past. And I know that they owe you something. The Justice in reverse. Happened in the past, this the devilish it was caught up in some devilish shit, and all of this is backfiring, or not maybe backfiring, but all of this is exploding in their face. Yeah, no justice, no peace. It's like they know they have done you wrong, and they are thinking about this, what happened in the past, and they feel depressed about it, or in their hermit mode. Organization, something about an organization. Yeah, sometimes, yeah, this can be, oh my god, yeah, this can be an organization, a religious organization that has held this person down for so many years, you know. And now they are struggling to get their life in order. They have to begin anew, that's what I'm hearing. Yeah, finally seen through the fog about this organization. Yeah, a thief. Yeah, this organization had some strict rules what you can do and what you not can do, you know? Someone you worked with had a bad reputation, or is thinking about their bad reputation, taking a pause. Someone has stolen something from this person, whether it's money, time, energy. Or anything. They feel that like they were robbed for something. There's an investigation going on. Yeah, and someone, yeah, something about sex as well. Someone is afraid for their, maybe they had a bad reputation in the past, and they are now try to find themselves or something, free themselves from this organization. Because of this organization or religious cult or what it is, this person did some very stupid things because they was in a sense covered by this organization. And this organization was just an illusion, you know? But yeah, spiritual attack. This is someone, something that there was an organization, as I said, that had some very strict rules. And if you didn't follow the rules, you got frozen out, you know? So this was their power over the people that were in this organization. The power over these people was, if you do not do this and that, we are pushing you out of the organization, and you have no friends, you're separated from your family, you separate from your friends, and there was some very strict rules. And there was some illegal things that were done about sex or something like that. And now there is an investigation or something, or had been an investigation. And this organization, this cult, also did mental manipulation on the people in this community, so that they, in a sense, hypnotized them or something, brainwashed them, so that they should do whatever the master said. That's what I'm hearing. And if you didn't do this, you were frozen out, as I said. Yeah. Yeah, they were breaking spiritual laws. And someone is breaking out of this, thinking about everything that happened in this organization, struggling with their bad conscience. Although this is not their fault, you know, when you brainwash, when you get pressed in a corner like this, you know, holy mountain. I see the holy mountain. Is this something that happened in the mountain, in a big organization that was hiding in the mountain, isolated themselves from other people so that no one should interfere in their community or something like that? Yeah, there had the staff working for them. Working hard work. And someone, they were told that everything that matters were money, money. Yeah, it's like everybody worked for this organization, didn't got paid for it or something like that. They were told that everything was supposed to go into this organization. Because there was for everybody's highest good or something like that. And there was no one. This is a corrupt system, you know. The leader of this organization misuse their power over the employees or this cult or something like that. Yeah, a karmic cycle. This is a karmic cycle for this person. It's like they want to get out of this. They know what's going on. Yeah, they want out in freedom. Take a leap of faith towards freedom. And Uranus, this is quick action out of this hopeless situation. Uranus. Yeah. Someone got a epiphany, a breakthrough, and take action towards their empowerment, their strength, their own strength. Yeah. And someone won't change, but have the opportunity, or have recently have the opportunity to make this change. Air sign, freedom, want freedom. Had an epiphany, a breakthrough. And now there, the Mars, you know, the planets have aligned, you know. Uranus and Mars has aligned. Uranus, Mars. Neptune are also in alignment. Yeah, so this is the Neptune, you know, this is spiritual. Neptune is very spiritual. But Neptune can also be very foggy, you know. So this is a very foggy spiritual community or something that have power over their people, and many people did something they normally wouldn't have done. So yeah. So this is this person or people I read for today, it's like this is holding them back in a sense, because they can't stop thinking about what they have done, you know. And this is also the journey to healing through all of this, you know. So if you feel that this is your reading, just continue your journey to true healing, and be kind to yourself. Don't beat yourself up, you know, because yeah, because this is a journey. You are going to be fine. Just be patient with yourself, and yeah. And I think this was your reading, Libra. I hope it helps, and I wish you all the best. Bye bye.